Hello everyone, welcome to Vikis channel. Tales of Tenali Raman. Tenali and the Thieves. One night, a few thieves decided to rob Tenali Raman's house. They crept in Tenali's backyard and stood hidden behind a large drum, waiting for the scholar and his wife to go to bed. Clever Tenali found out about the plan. But he knew that he was alone and not very strong enough to be able to fight the thieves off. So he thought of a plan. Tenali Raman collected all the gold and valuables in his house and stored them in a safe place. Then in a loud voice, he told his wife, "Dear, I think we should hide all our gold and valuables in the well in our garden. The thieves have become very active these days. We never know when they might target our house." Tenali then filled a large wooden box with bricks and stones. He took it to the well in his garden and dropped it. With a loud splash, the box fell into the water and drowned. Tenali and his wife then put out the lights and went to bed. The thieves in Tenali's backyard heard everything that he said and the loud splash that came from the garden. They thought, "Why risk going into the house when the gold lies in the well?" So they went to check the well. The well was a deep one. The thieves thought, "This little well is a very deep one. We will drown if we try to go down into it to fetch the box." One of the thieves suggested, "Let's take the water out instead. When all the water in the well has been drawn, we will get the box easily." The plan seemed good, so they got down to work. All night they kept on drawing water from the well. All the plants in the garden were watered nicely. When the sky turned purple with the dawn, but much to the thieves' disappointment, the water level of the well did not go down by an inch. When Tenali Raman got up, he saw the thieves were hard at work in his garden. He called out to them, "You may stop that now. All the plants have been watered." The thieves were ashamed of their greed. They stopped drawing water and ran before the king's guards caught them. Tenali Raman decides to paint. Once King Krishnadevaraya built a large mansion. He wished that its walls be decorated with paintings. A very famous painter was asked to take the responsibility. After a year, he reported that his work was complete. The king with his Ashtadiggajas and several other courtiers went to inspect the mansion. The work was indeed exquisite and one of its kinds. The king was very impressed by the painter. He was proud of himself to have been able to get such an accomplished painter to do the job. Just then, Tenali spotted that one of the figures did not have a limb. He pointed it out to the king. The king was taken by surprise. Just so that Tenali would ignore the defect, he said, "You might imagine the missing limb. That's the beauty of the painting." Now it was Tenali's turn to be surprised. He thought the king may have got a famous painter to do the paintings. But why would he not accept that there's a defect? Tenali decided to make the king understand that one must always accept the truth, no matter how bitter it is. He went to the king's court after some days and said, "Your Majesty, your mansion has inspired me to paint. And today I have organized an exhibition of my paintings. I would like to invite you to visit my exhibition." The king agreed. When the king visited the exhibition, he was shocked to find that Tenali had hung strange paintings all around the room. One canvas there was a picture of a foot. On another canvas there was a painting of a hand. The king asked, "I am sorry, but I do not find these pictures very beautiful. You have only painted the limbs. Where is the rest of the person?" Tenali smiled and said, "Your Majesty, one must imagine the rest of the person That is the beauty of these paintings. The king was ashamed of himself. He realized what Tenali was referring to. The Red Peacock. King Krishnadevaraya was very fond of birds. He had a vast collection of red birds in his palace. One day, a courtier decided to get some favors from the king. He bought a peacock and hired a painter to paint it red. The painter did such a good job that when he was done, the peacock looked as if it was naturally red. The courtier then took the bird to the king and said, "Your Majesty, this is the rarest kind of peacock in the world. It lives in the dense forest and is very difficult to catch. I have spent a huge amount of money to catch it for you. It will be a great addition to your collection." The king was surprised as well as very pleased. He offered 1,000 gold coins to the courtier for the bird. The courtier was overjoyed that his trick had worked. He bowed to the king and left the court. Tenali Raman, who was present at the court, suspected that something was not right with the peacock. When he went near the bird, he could smell paint. He knew at once that the courtier had tricked the king. The next day, Tenali bought 5 peacocks and asked his servants to find the painter who had painted the peacock for the courtier. In no time, the painter was brought before Tenali, who then ordered the painter to paint the 5 birds. The painter painted the birds in red like he had done before. Tenali then took the birds and the painter to the court. The king was shocked to see the 5 red peacocks. The courtier said that this bird was the rarest of the rare kind. "How did you manage to find so many of them?" he asked Tenali. Tenali first asked if the king would pay him 1,000 gold coins for all the 5 birds. The king agreed. Then Tenali said, "Your Majesty, please come closer and sniff at the birds." When the king smelled the birds, he realized they were all painted. He was furious. "How dare you play a trick on me like that? I will sentence you to death." Tenali said, "Your Majesty, the bird that you had bought from your courtier the other day was also just another peacock painted red. This gentleman himself had done it." The king asked the painter and he confessed that the courtier had paid him to paint the peacock. Trembling, he said, "Your Majesty, had I known that the courtier was planning to trick you, I would never have painted the peacock for him." The king rewarded the painter for his excellent work and the courtier was punished for his evil deed. The Shrewd Businessman. King Krishnadevaraya often took pleasure in putting riddles across to Tenali Raman. One day, the king asked, "Tenali, tell me, people from which caste are the most intelligent and which the most stupid?" Tenali Raman thought for a while. "Your Majesty, people from the businessman community is the more intelligent and shrewd, while the Brahmins are the most stupid." On hearing this, the king was amazed. How could the Brahmins, who were the most learned and wise, be the most stupid of all people? He said, "Can you prove it?" Tenali said he could. Tenali then called upon the Rajguru, the royal priest. He said, "Wise one, the king wishes that you have your choti off. The choti is the bit of hair at the back of the head which is left unshaven and is symbolic of a Hindu man's pride." The Brahmin was taken back. He said, "Your Majesty, I have tended this choti for years now and it is a symbol of my pride. But since you have desired that I have shave it off, but I cannot just give it away. I would need something in return." The king said he would grant any amount of money if the Brahmin shaved his choti. So the Brahmin asked for 5 gold coins. He took the money, shaved his choti in the court and left. Then Tenali called upon the richest businessman in the city. When the man learned of the king's wish, he had, "Your Majesty, I will shave off this choti, but I am a poor man. When my brother got married, I have to spend 5,000 gold coins to keep this choti. Then when my daughter got married, I had to pay 10,000 gold coins for the sake of this choti. It will cost me a lot of money to keep this choti." The king said, "Your loss would be compensated if you have your choti off." The businessman was given 15,000 gold coins and the barber proceeded to shave his choti when the businessman said, "Be careful. I have sold this choti to the king. It belongs to the king now. So be careful when you shave it. Do not forget that it is the king's choti that you are shaving." At this, the king burst out angrily. "How dare you say that? You mean to say that I am so crazy so as to have my choti shaved?" He ordered the guards to take the businessman away. Tenali Raman smiled. When the king had calmed down, he said, "Do you realize how the businessman got to keep the 15,000 gold coins and his choti at the same time, while the Brahmin shaved his choti for just 5 gold coins?" The king praised Tenali for his exceptional judgment. Hope you all loved this story, and in coming videos, we will come up with more and more stories you can enjoy. Thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe our channel for more videos, and do not forget to tap on the bell icon to receive the updated videos of our channel. Thank you. Bye. And let's meet with another exciting story. Bye.